My late husband and I were pioneers, legends, and icons in the Taekwondo world. He was the highest ranked non-oriental in the entire world. I am the highest ranked female in the entire world of Taekwondo. My cancer journey started when my husband was diagnosed with a rare form of treatable cancer. And then 4 years ago, he began to have symptoms and the treatment wasn't working and keeping it under control like it had in the past. So my husband passed away in February, and then the following June, I was diagnosed with breast cancer. I had several different groups contact me to see if I would let them evaluate my case and come to their facilities, but I knew the quality and the care and the genuine concern of Watson Clinic, and it was already my second home because I'd spent 3 years in the hospital with him and 3 years here at Watson Clinic, and I knew that the treatment here, it couldn't be beat anywhere, and the love and concern and building those new relationships is something I wasn't interested in doing anywhere else either. So it was difficult. I remember the first time when I came in, because it was the first time I had an appointment with my name on it. And when I walked in and saw my doctor, Dr. Mullaparthy, I could tell by the look on her face that it was like, I hate that this is happening to you, but I guarantee you I'm going to take good care of you. It's not just that you get good treatment, but it's also knowing that people really do care about you. When we started off with 3 rounds of chemo, then we went to surgery and did a lumpectomy, and then now I'm back into chemo treatments again. I have 6 more rounds of chemo, then from there radiation, and then we're home free. Rather than letting the diagnosis take control of me, I've taken the diagnosis and said, no, I'm going to use this to help other people. So I've started looking for ways that I can reach out and inspire and encourage other people. So since this started, I started a Facebook page with inspirational videos that help people go through their nightmare circumstances by sharing my circumstances and now how I have taken those and used that as a driving force to make a better person out of myself. I was telling a friend of mine the other day, they said, well, how did it go? And I said, you know, they're a second family to me.